Welcome to another NUCIDA video. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time. It's never been easier to manage tests at scale than with Xray Test Management. Xray is a Jira native software test management app that ensures your testing and development teams are collaborating to achieve the highest quality products. With Xray, you'll never deliver broken or untested code again. Xray is a comprehensive test management solution that uses Jira native issue types to specify, organize, plan, and execute tests. With Xray, you can create your tests and add preconditions. Organize them using the test sets or the test repository. Plan your test strategy, and finally execute tests and report the status. Today I want to focus on the new available Xray reporting and customization features that bring a lot of new solutions on the table that will support your daily testing business. So, it's worth making a deep dive. I recommend integrating these into your testing business that save your time and offer a lot of insights for test managers. Starting with the reporting center, there are multiple ways for you to access the new feature. You can do it both through your project navigation, similar to where we have the testing board. You can go here to the More section and drag and drop the reporting center into the tab, which you should do. Or you can also use the App Store with the new geo navigation. It's located here. To the left, you can expand Xray and see the reporting center right here. You can use either of the two. It's the same new full-fledged dedicated reporting section that will list all the reports that Xray has, and you'll be able to see a preview of them and the scope of each report. So this allows you to understand which reports are traceability focus, which ones are coverage focus, and which ones are more inventory reports, and also be covered within the scope of this demo. And you can also start any of them, because you might not use all the reports. You might just need test coverage and requirement traceability, for instance. Therefore, you have the Start tab, which is a lot easier for you to access and to go straight forward to the reports you use the most. Now, if we go into the test execution, this report suffers a couple of changes. Now it's a lot more powerful. So, you do have the expandable version here. We'll cover it in a bit, but if you press Generate Report, you are presented with the key to the test execution, the summary of the test execution itself. Any Jira field or Xray custom field that you want can also be showcased here in the columns. This is fully configurable. For example, if you need to see story points for the test execution, you can have them here, and you can drag and drop them and organize them to your liking. Thus, you have important details about your testing, like the test environment, the count of tests inside the test execution, the respective test plan, the test execution is associated to, and the status of the tests inside this execution, plus the number of known defects. Now, if we want to see the expanded version, which has even more data and supports parameterized testing, you can toggle that on and press Generate Report, and that's where it will show you a lot more details. First, you can see immediately the test types columns. This shows you inside a test execution how many tests are of the type manual, cucumber, generic, or other. Because you can have custom test types, what's the progress, the success rate, elapsed time, and any linked defects. Now, if we want to see the parameterization or the iterations of each test, you can also go here to the columns and add the iterations and parameters column, which will now showcase that. For example, on the store page navigation and usability test execution, we have 11 iterations. If we expand, you can see that first inside this execution, you have all of these tests. And then inside each of these tests, you can see that for the first one and the third one, you have 5 iterations. After opening the iterations, you can now see that iteration 1 is using Maestro and MasterCard as data set parameters. Iteration number 2 is based on Visa and Chrome, whereas iteration 3 is using American Express and Mozilla Firefox, and all of them have their own status. It's a lot easier for you to understand the outcomes of your parameterized tests. If you press it, you'll be redirected to the testing board, and Xray will load the actual test run for you, where you have all the iterations inside, and where you can see all the steps and the outcomes of the testing activities that you just performed. Again, it's a big change from what we had previously for the ones that are comfortable in acquaintance to the scope of the test execution report in the data center. The cloud version is now much more improved to what we have. Lot more powerful reporting features support you in your day-to-day software testing activities now. Now, if we move into the defect traceability report, another report that we also discussed and showcased first, it's important for us to just cover quickly what the defect is within Xray. As you know, a defect represents any Jira work item that you want to consider as a defect. By default, it can be a bug, but you can have custom work items that you want to consider the defects. And those will be showcased together with the outcomes of your test executions. And they will be used to do the calculations with the requirement traceability report and defect traceability report. For the first defect, here's an example of that report. So once again, you have the option to filter and to select which projects you want to see. You might want to filter through assignee or through component resolution. Again, you have a lot of options, but you can also filter the defects. For instance, you might want to see all defects in your project that are connected to requirements. Defects that are linked to a user story or to an epic, or defects that aren't connected to anything. Because it might be important for you just to see, holistically speaking, which defects you have that are currently just waiting for someone to pinpoint what part of your project they are affecting, which scope they need to be tested against, etc. And you can also do a quick filter through the defect priority. Thus, you might want to see just the highest priority defects. If we don't have any, we might want to see just the low ones, or we might just want to see the full page. In this scenario, you can see the defect XSP4/28 that is linked to a test execution with a test run inside it. You can press the details to be redirected to the test run. Additionally, you can see immediately that this given test run is currently marked as failed, and it's linked to this test and to this user story. Of course, you can have full traceability, almost like a defect story telling you when the defect happened and what it is affecting in your project for the ones that are connected. Again, for the ones that are not connected, it gives you tools to understand where they need to focus your defects and bugs investigation. Now we are jumping into the usage monitor. So, the usage monitor is an admin tool that needs to be accessed by admins into your Manage App section, and under Xray, you should be able to see the usage monitor. This is the experience in the first run. In broad terms, the usage monitor will do a big calculation for you to check all your Xray entities and how they are being covered. Try to understand if you see or detect any anti-patterns. And this is something that you can run once per day. Usually it will take a little bit, but the outcome of it will be a table with all your entities' counts and with different data points. Therefore, you'll be able to explore and to guide your teams into improving and fostering adoption of Xray, or into seeing anti-patterns that can be worked upon by any team member. So again, first you have a count of entities, and it can go from either the amount of custom test statuses that you have to the number of manual tests versus cucumber or generic tests. This can be used, for instance, as an automation of option measurement. Imagine you can have a given threshold for a project, and the usage monitor might allow you to see, okay, I have a threshold of 20% manual tests, 80% generic or cucumber based. You can see those numbers here and make sure the math is adding up correctly. Then you have a count of all the Xray issue type-based entities like tests, preconditions, test executions, dynamic test plans, etc. Since dynamic test plans are an Xray Enterprise-only feature, you can also understand here if the uniqueness of Xray Enterprise is being used or not. Important is the top 5 count for projects with the most requirements without tests. This should be, in theory, the top 5 projects with the weakest test coverage. By the way, you can also see the projects with more test coverage, projects with most tests, with most manual tests, or with most generics, for instance. This is also a good example for you to understand which projects within your organization are focusing more on testing or using more test automation. Therefore, on those projects, you might need to do some extra rounds of manual exploratory testing to make sure that the automation results are going as intended. Or you can try to see, for instance, from all of your projects, which ones are using more datasets iterations, like it was shown on the test execution list report. Thus, understand parameterized test adoption if you have all the teams using this approach to reduce the number of tests they need to generate, and to see if they're leveraging the parameterized testing solutions that Xray provides. Then you have counts for tests. Assuming you would have accounts for tests that are created using Test Case Designer, another Xray Enterprise feature. That is important for you to see how it's being used by your users. And then manual tests with most steps. This should be, in theory, the more complex manual test scenarios that your testers are executing, or tests that are being reused the most. So tests that are mostly available in test plans, or most test sets, are being used a lot more in test executions versus other tests, or even tests with most versions. Tests that are currently linked to test case versioning, another Xray Enterprise feature. Besides that, you can also check your preconditions, test sets, test executions, or test plans, etc. It's always going back to the same, which is giving you tools to understand adoption. Being able to detect patterns to improve the outcome of the testing activities of your team members, and then anti-patterns, which are, based on our experience of Xray usage, common behaviors indicating that Xray is not being used to its fullest. For instance, if you have a lot of resolved requirements without tests, even though you're using a test management solution, you're not considering tests as the definition of done for a requirement for a user story. Similar to that can be said for manual tests without any test steps. In theory, it's awkward that you're using manual test types without any steps. That means without any definition of the testing activities the tester needs to perform. Likewise, you can have manual tests with too many steps. A large number of test steps might indicate that you're trying to do everything in a single test, where, in theory, you should split it accordingly into separate tests, what actually needs to be tested. And then test executions without test runs, or tests without execution. This may indicate tests that are not being used anymore that you can clear up, or the tests need to be improved. Additionally, on top, you can also do a check per project instead of seeing a global vision of the status of your Jira site. If you go to the project tab, you can select up to 5 projects and see project-related entities. To streamline the analysis that you are performing, you can have on the view set settings and showcase all your items expanded, are all collapsed to improve the digest of the data. You can also press the export through a CSV, where you can choose the delimiter, and the visible data will be shown to you in a CSV file that you can then use on an Excel or anything that you want to create some kind of reporting on top of this. Finally, let's just go over quickly the custom test statuses and custom test step statuses. So again, back to the Jira site. If you go into the Manage Apps again, Admin Only, you can configure custom test statuses and custom test step statuses. These will be the statuses of your coverage, and again, these will be given by the outcome of your testing activities. We can consider ones like blocked, or we can also have ones that are, for instance, skipped, that we might want to say, okay, this test is no longer needed, it was skipped. This and the same can be done to the step itself. So, this one will be marked as not run. Now we can say that this status is final. This status can be given to a test execution with a lot of tests inside, or to a test plan with a lot of tests inside. Then you have the option to either enable this for all projects, or to activate it project by project. For now, let's select only this sample project 4, and let's press add again. You have the new status. Thus you can see which projects are enabled, so it's correct. It's only enabled for the online store number 4, and the same can be done for the test steps. So, for this step, let's use the skipped status. This one, let's give it a bit of a blue color and status on this one, let's mark it as to do. And this one, let's enable it for all projects. Now, I go into a test execution for a given test plan, let's just give it a refresh to see if the changes are propagated. I'm on the correct project number 4. I have the status here, and I have the blocked one, which is good. Let's try to perform the testing activities. Okay, there we go. We have a test run and the description. So, on this first step, imagine that we no longer need to add one more item to the shopping cart scenario. There we go. We have the skip step that can mark it like this, and then we can say that everything else is green, and we can mark the full test run as passed or as blocked again. And this is totally up to us. We have full control about which statuses are relevant for us, which ones are marked as final or not. If we go back to the test execution again, this one is still marked as executing. But we can say that it was blocked because it had a skipped step. If I go into my sample project 3, and let's just go quickly into a test execution, can this be this one? I have a lot of tests here, but I do not have the block statuses, so the new feature is working properly. This is relevant for bigger corporations or companies that have a lot of uniqueness into their testing flows, and you might need specific statuses for your teams, but you might not need them for all teams. Therefore, you might not want to overcomplicate the outcomes of your testing and the reporting that you have. So, using customized test steps and test statuses will be an ideal solution for you. Test management shouldn't be a burden to your team. That's why over 10 million testers and 10,000 companies in 135 countries worldwide trust Xray to deliver the highest quality products faster than ever before. Break the silo between testing and development. Integrate them under the same tool set with Xray for Jira, and NUCIDA supports you to achieve that. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time, or even produce a separate video about your topic. Please also check out our other over 200 videos about software quality. Happy testing. See you next time.